Okay, good morning, class. Let's start by you and me to yourself. The network is still okay. So today is our first class, and I can see your names. I can see your names on the Zoom. So I'm seeing, okay, this is Charlie Ben that sent me a mail. I can see you all. This network is.
Yes, it's me, Ma.
You're welcome. Okay, today the first thing we are doing in the class is to
thank
actually
you.
Yes, and I'm so just saying Yanolua. All this Jakaye, you cannot, all your lines are not entering, no. Which kind of where are you staying? Where is he staying that? Mr. Jakaye, he has so many devices. None of them is entering. Okay, so let's just start. Today we are actually going to start with I'm sorry, I actually was out of the class, out of my office, so I have to be using the iPad to take this class. So just take me the way I am for today, but I hope we can do this next week. I just had an emergency, I have to come and see the piece. That has not made me to out of the class, but we just do what we can today. This network is poor. Hello, can you hear me? Just unmute yourself. Can you hear me? I will tell you when to mute. If I say nice, I will tell you to mute. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma, we can hear you. I can hear you.
Oh, great, great. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for that response. So the course we are going to be looking at is called ENG 421, and is a new trends in syntax. And that's what we're going to be treating in this particular course. Ajakaye cannot enter, it's just the two of you, but I'm recording. So hopefully those that cannot join now can join. Now what we're going to do first is to actually look at the basics about the class. So let me ask, how many of you have actually read the course material before now? Have you read the course guide? Because I gave you an assignment that I did not see many of you submitting it in the virtual learning environment. Did you submit your assignment? Did you know I gave you an assignment there? You're supposed to have submitted last week.
No.
Last week.
Yes, I gave you exam. If you said you read the introductory video, so how come you did not see the assignment? How many of you have visited the virtual learning environment? You can meet yourself and answer me.
I was able to see the introductory video you uploaded.
Okay,
the two of them, like the first
one. The one on the YouTube?
Yes, the one on YouTube that is.
Okay. But you didn't go
yes,
to
the one on YouTube that is on our portal.
Uh-huh. So if you have gone to the portal, I'm talking about the portal. I gave an assignment there on the portal. Because we're going to be doing most of our work there. You didn't see the assignment. You didn't see the assignment I did there. Under the topic one.
No, I didn't.
No, it is there. It is there. I gave it. Unfortunately, because I'm not in the office, so I will not be able to screenshot. Maybe it's my phone outside. Okay, no problem. I'm going to extend the time for that. It was supposed to prepare you for this class. We were supposed to start last week, but then because of the accreditation, we're busy accreditation, so I could not. But I was thinking you guys would have done the assignment and prepare us for this class. Okay, so let's start by looking at the how many of you have read the course guide? How many of you have read the course guide? Have you read the course guide for the course material? Have you read it? You did not read it?
I've gone through it a little bit, Ma, but
yeah, because this is what we want to discuss today. Now, if you have been to the virtual learning environment, you should know what we want to discuss, and you should have been able to prepare for this. Okay, so So I don't really like class where I just come and be able to be talking. I don't do that. I like to interrupt my students. And then even though your I know syntax is funny and people will say it's difficult, but then if you prepare for it, I told you in my introductory video, the last class, because they were cooperating, I was able to actually achieve a lot, even though it was still, what do you call it? Even though it was still the same syntax that people are afraid of, but people passed it out with good grace too. With good grace too. And the same question I've been studying, I didn't know what to stand on my questions, but they passed. And I saw that what I've always advocated for is the facilitation, but then I need your cooperation for us to be able to do this. No, we can do this, but I need to have your cooperation. That is just the truth of the matter. So please, when I give you the next assignment, make sure you do it. Make sure you read up. I think I've also, even if you, many of you have read the lesson plan, the course plan, the plan for the course, because I put it already on the virtual learning. How many of you have read it? Have you read it? The course
plan. I've not started reading it, my just.
It's just one page.
Maybe
maximum 2 pages. You know, the course material now. I made
the
course.
I really wasn't.
Guys, I need your cooperation for us to do this.
Hello, Ma.
Hello. Yeah.
Yes, Ma, I can hear you, Ma.
Yeah. So I say I need your cooperation for us to do this. Do you know? I need your cooperation.
Yes, Ma.
If I say read something, please read it ahead because I am going to facilitate. The last time I actually did lecture, but this time around I'm going to facilitate because we are supposed to work within a plan and all of that. The other time I threw all those things to the winds and I did lecture. And it worked for me. So let me try facilitation and see how it goes too. So there's why you have to all read ahead of the class. We are going to read module 1. That one we're going to teach in the next class. So you have to. Now, what are we talking about? This course guide is to tell you, to give you the in-total details about what we are going to do in this course. That is what it is about. You understand what I'm saying now? So now,
yes,
you need
yes,
to have an overview of the course itself. Now, if you already have that, it helps you to prepare and to know what I want to do. So at any point in time, it prepares you for what we are going to do. And that is why it is important you do it. What is the objective of the course itself? The course is expected to help you. The course is expected to help you. I mean, the objective of the course is that it's really, one of the things you're supposed to do now is that to understand the grammar, the transformation relative grammar as it grew. And then as grew over the year from standard theory to the minimalist program that we have now. It grew over time. Now, if you have done your, which I expect that you have done before you go to 400 level where you're doing this course, you have done your 100 and your 200 prerequisite syntactic courses, those ones would have prepared you for all the details of those stories, of those grammars. Standard theory is where we started from. Where Chomsky started from, that is where we now go to, before we go to GP syntax and before we go to minimalist program. So now if you have gotten this, this helps you to build up an understanding. But I know because syntax, most people don't look at it, it's like mathematics, so they just get scared, they don't even take time to enjoy it. So this is one thing that this helps you to do. It gives you this overview to understand what is the theory about. When you have understood that, you can now, this course also helps you to be able to apply it to using the analysis of structures. Now, I'm not saying sentences because you're going to analyze are not just sentences. You're going to look at even what about phrases? So what about the morphosyntax of those, of the words? So these are the things we are going to look at. So this course is going to look at those things. And we are going to have practical application of this theory to structures. And that's why I say it's important that you cooperate with me by reading ahead. One of the things I found with the other class, the class that I told us that some of them actually practice ahead. So when we're actually taking any particular structural analysis, they are able to, we are able to actually say, okay, I've also tried this sentence. Oh, but this is the what I meant on the way. This is the blocking that I meant. So it helps us. I know some of you probably you have tried this course before and it didn't go the way you wanted. Now, this is the more reason you actually put in more interest and effort. So that once and for all, you get through this course and it is over. So it is very, very important that you read it. This is the point I'm making. So this course is going to give you the He's going to give you the theory. He's going to explain to you what is different between minimalist program and the GP syntax, which is the last one. Then he's going to show you how you can actually apply the minimalist theory. You know, minimalist theory is funny that it's mostly an economic theory. Why is it taking this book forever to bring this thing? It's okay to change it slow. So it's 12% now. So it is an economic theory. So it's talking about the economy of derivation. It's coming about the economy of transformation and the economy of. So these are the things that it is talking about. So this is very, very important. Sorry, please. This is saying battery. Okay, thank you. So this is very important. So people can go. So these are the things that you is to help you to understand. Now, okay, yes, so the modifications over the years, I've mentioned that, then the work and how to apply them, how the modification work, and then to determine their strengths and weaknesses. So this, I think this is one I've not mentioned. So I got just the course material here now. But what am I saying? Now, beyond that, you also need to... Hello, Madam Mutiat. I will meet you if you don't meet yourself. Okay. I want this part to be party, but Mutiat is making noise. Mutiat, you are making noise. Okay, so now I can please. Okay, now I can have some peace now. I'm muted all of you. So now what I'm saying is that now you are going to walk through this course material and look at it. When you look at module one, the study unit that you have, what do you have there? In your module one, we are going to look at the innovations in the minimalist program. How is it different? How is the minimalist program different from the other one? So that is the first we are going to deal with, and that's what we're going to deal with next week. We are going to look at how it is different. When you look at the concept of government, it is not there. So that means it's different from government and binding. Then when you also look at the approach, this one now, it is from bottom up. So these are the things we are going to look at, but we are going to look at it holistically. You are going to also see that the case of what is maintained is the PF and the LF. They are maintained in the two theories or modification of the TGG. But then you now have also what is different, the spell out stage that was not in the other one. So these are the things we are going to look at there. We are going to look at the notation styles. Then the economic principles of the minimalist framework. I told you that the minimalist framework is an economic principle. So you will see now that how you can do the same thing with as shorter a way or approach as possible. So now you have brought it to the minimalist of going through a long process, like you actually have in the standard theory, you are suddenly reduced to the barest minimum of what you need to do. Then we also look at the operations. There are different operations that actually take place in the process of the derivation. So these are the different operations we have. I think if I'm correct, now about six. About six different syntactic operations. So we are going to look at them. We'll look at them. Then we'll look at then also the processes. We'll look at all the processes. And you see also another thing is that the lexeme has been brought to the fore in this theory. Unlike when you have the notations, the syntactic notations before. So this is also another interesting part of this particular theory. So we are going to look at what is different about this theory. What is different about this theory? So it's very important that you look at all this thing. Sorry, my slides are not here. That's why I could not share. I told you I'm out of office now, so my computer is in my office. So, but we are going to do a lot of the practicals. Now the syntactic processes, we are going to apply them. Now, when you look at the BFA structure, we will look at the BFA structure because it is different from the X-bar theory in that now this is one of these with the lexicality. Whereas the expert theory actually just looks at the concept itself. So this is also another thing that is very different about the minimalist program. So we are going to look at all of these things. And how do these things affect you? Now, what you need to know is that it is not just enough to know these theories. You should be able to apply them. So you need to apply them. And that is why we are also going to, I've left the last 2 weeks for us to do practicals. Because when we did it with the theory in the first 4 weeks, we are going to use the last practicals. That's all we're going to do. It has worked for me before, and I know it will work for me again. And I know it will work for you. Because then when you, because I set my questions in such a manner that you have to actually do structural analysis. So it's not just that we just come and speak grammar here. We'll speak a little grammar, but we'll do more practical things for you to do the syntactic analysis of structures and even construct yours. So because that's all what makes this course what you're going through. So we are going to have the breakdown of the things that this first week now, we are going to look at this introduction of the course guide and what it's supposed to do for you. I'm supposed to guide you through the course and give you an overview of all the course. And the following week, now I'm going to look at module one. What makes this particular theory different? How is it a better, or if you think, if you like, you tell me it's a worse. If it's a worse modification, you are very free to say so. That's why you're a student of, you are a student in a university. You can challenge what has gone before. There is a university and the knowledge does not end. If not, nobody will get a PhD anymore. Am I correct? So that is, this is what you need to do. So we are also going to just remember also that you need to look at your course materials. Now in your course material, you have what you call further reading. Now the further reading is not there for decoration. Now there are references and further reading, you know why? Now the references is that the thing that have been referred by the people that wrote the course material for you. And then the further reading is for you to also read beyond the class. We try as much as possible to make sure that we set our question within what you have been taught. But then the reality is if you are going to be a graduate, you should be able to go beyond what was taught in your class. So we expect you to be able to read that. So please pay attention to the further reading section and make sure you are reading the course. I mean, you access the course materials. You know, the university has very rich library, e-library. So you should make use of it. I think if I have your email, unfortunately, I don't know. Normally, I'll be sent your data for me to send you email to even a reminder for this course. But we are going to be using that, using mostly our virtual learning environment. So I'm going to post there the document of the e-library access so that you can access them and get many materials and read up. So I will upload that material for you after this class. Then the assessment. You know, normally we have 70% in the exam. And then your, what you call your TMA, your continuous assessment takes off 30%. And I don't accept the university policy changes. For now, you have to do your 30 questions. You have to attempt the 3 of them for you to be able to get your result. So take note of that. So your assessment comes in the 2 ways of the final examination, the semester examination, and also the tutor mark assignment. So ensure that you take note of these ones. And I expect by now, being from 400 level, you should be familiar with some of these things. But I'm just telling you that this is what we're also going to do in this particular course. So you take note of that. Then let me see now. Okay, I've mentioned the marking scheme. So now you make sure that your... Now the first, your TMAs, the way they are broken down, if you look at the course material, is by modules. But the dates are given, I think you always have the dates posted in your course material on your portal, if I want to believe so. So with that one, you shall know when the time you're supposed to take your TMA and all of that. So you need to take sure that you are following this and you do all your TMAs. And then during the exam, because you know the regulation about the exam. So like I told you, when we have done this fall, we have the first 4 modules, when we treat them, then the remaining 2 weeks will be practically for you to practice all that you have learned. Then we want to also see that, okay, now how do you get the most from this course? It's by cooperating with your lecturer. It's by cooperating with your facilitator. It's by making sure that the assignments are done. I have given an assignment already, but none of you have done it. I'm not happy about that. I'm not happy about that, because I think a time will come I may have to just rope it into part of your examinations. So you need to do your assignment.
Don't mind, ma'am.
You have done yours?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, okay, please. Okay, let me finish, then you will share with us. Is that okay?
All right.
But did you post it back in the chat room? Did you post it back there?
Yes, I post. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay, I will look at it then. Sorry, I'm actually taking so much of my time. I'll look at it, because I actually tried to check now, but I didn't notice that. Okay, I will check again, and then I will rate it and let you see it. But thank you very much. That is very, very good. I can see you're very serious. So we are going to, so these are the things that we are going to be looking at. Then I also have mentioned at the beginning that this ENG421 is actually built on the previous course, especially ENG222. ENG222 dealt extensively with all the other theories as they grew. So you are supposed to have mastered that. So with that, you should not actually have, but it takes a lot of things on GPC. So you should not have problem flowing into this particular course. So we are going to be looking at this. Then some tests and some invention. I mentioned that we are going to have many static operations. So we have like operation agree, operation merge. Now, if you are thinking operation merge in terms of that you are talking about the way you use it normally in English, you are merging one word to another, no, that's not the way it works. The way it works is that it is a syntactic operation that has to do with the transformational process. So we need to learn this. So you have a page there that talks about how you actually do this. Or you look at operation copy, and you now look at, it's copy and paste. No, because you don't have operation paste. Do you have operation paste in static theory? No, you don't have it. So that will tell you now that it is not the same thing. So operation merge, operation, or if you talk about the M command, what does it mean? It is about the maximum mode, where the C command is what? Is you also have the C command. Then you of course have which has to do with constituent command. So what you talk about government and what you bind it, these are elements in GBC syntax. So, but our focus here is actually about the minimalist program. So this is what we are going. So you familiarize yourself with these terms. If you do, you will not get confused, because if you don't, you go and be looking at copy, I'll be thinking that copy has to do with copying and paste, which you are familiar with in computer. No. Your copy is actually an element reproducing, replicating itself within a structure. So there are two different things. So you need to master these terms. So please take time and go through the terms. Now, anyone you don't understand, you can post it in the chat on the virtual learning environment and let us look at it. So we can respond and then somebody can help us. So don't let us do that. Then I will also suggest, if you think you need it, which I think with the virtual environment we have now may not be too necessary. We had the WhatsApp chat room there where people were practicing and doing a lot of things. But I think we can do that also in our chat in the virtual learning environment. So you can make maximum use of it. There are many features there that can actually help with our teaching and with our learning. So I want you to make maximum use of it. So like I said, we are going to treat module one in the next class. And that is going to talk about innovations in the minimalist program. What makes it different? What is new about it? What is it adding? What is it teaching you? What is it telling you? And I mentioned something like spellout. Spellout was not in the GB syntax, but it's the same in the minimalist program. And why is it different? But the LF and PF are still there. So why were they retained? So these are the things that we should look at and then discuss in the next class. So when you talk about the economy of representation and economy of derivation, what are you talking about? What do they mean? And of course, when you talk about the common operations, like I mentioned, operation agree, operation copy, these are things that you should look at and see what are they supposed to do in the syntactic process. So you need to master them and be able to, so that by the time we are coming to class the next class, then you'll be able to tell us. So these are essentially the things that we are going to be talking about and be looking at. So at this time, I want to give you room to say yes. I'll meet everybody. And I hope those people that are having, or you can actually unmute yourself if you want to speak, because some of you are having, you seem to be having some background meeting. So but don't let us do meeting inside meeting. This is class. This is class, even though I'm where I am, that you are where you are, but this is class. So let us give that respect. So Ajakaya, you can unmute yourself now and present to us your assignment. Then any other person can ask whatever they want to say after that. Mr. Jakaye. Mr. Jakaye, you can unmute yourself. Mr. Jakaye, you can unmute yourself.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
Good. Okay, so let us have, what did you present your assignment? Let's have your assignment.
What I presented is the general aim of the course.
Okay.
In it, I mentioned that it gives us the opportunity to give us the opportunity of seeing times. It also leads us into the general aim of the course itself. Then also, it gives us the opportunity to see how the examination will be taken and the rest. Now, those are the things I put down.
Okay, good. But so what specifically did I ask you people to do? What did I specifically say the assignment is about? What is specifically? Can you remember what I said specifically?
The question is, the objective of the study guide.
Yeah, course guide. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay. I mean the course guide, yes.
At least one objective of the course. Not what I wanted. What do you think that it is meant to achieve? At least that I said it should give me just one. I think is that correct? Okay.
I think you mentioned like three.
Okay. Yeah, but what you mentioned, you're actually going outside the objective. But it's okay. At least that you attempted it. I'm giving you a clap. So I'm giving a clap for that.
Thank you, ma.
Does anybody want to make comment? Sorry, the cob. I don't know.
Sorry, ma.
Okay, you still want to say something?
Hello.
Okay.
Yes, okay. I'm trying to check back. I think the thing did not submit well. Maybe that was why you didn't see it.
Okay.
Yes.
Because I still want the other people to submit this.
Okay.
Oluwa, do you have something to say? Mutia, do you have something to say? Charlie Bien, Godwin, let me tell you what I can say. Does any of you have anything to say? You can unmute yourself. You can unmute yourself if you want to say something.
I did actually know that there was an assignment for us to do. So is the assignment still open? I didn't even know that there was like an assignment there. So I didn't know that there was a closing date for it or something. I knew there was supposed to be an assignment.
If you have gone to the portal, you would have seen it. Is it under topic one? You would have seen it. I didn't know Abedu for me that, but he saw it and he did it. Uh-huh. So please, I'm giving people to tomorrow to do it. So that Thursday, whatever I do, that's a synchronous chat. Then we can discuss outside of that. So please, I'm going to set up a topic for this. Is that okay? Oraluwa.
Yes, ma. Yes, ma.
Okay, listen.
Hello, ma.
I am listening.
Okay, ma. I will turn in the assignment before the end of today.
Otherwise, I
discovered that I was meant to do an assignment, but I would no. I will turn it in before the end of today, ma'am. I will turn it in, ma'am.
Great.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what about Abiodun Mutiat? Are you doing yours? Unmute yourself.
Emma, is the assignment still open?
It is. Please do it. It's still open.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, do it. Okay, so then now I want to comment on all that I've discussed beyond assignment. Please, does anybody have anything to say about this? Any challenge, anything you need, any further thing? I've also sent you one e-resource for you to read under the e-library. I sent something there. So you can all access, but
yes. Today
I
will also
say, you saw it. Good. I also sent I'm going to get this thing now for you to also have, what is it called now, the access to the e-library of the university, so that you can also read up on this. So I sent some e-resources. So if you are ready, so let me know. Now, please, do you have any expectation? I want you to share it with us. Any expectation in this course? Do you have anything you want to tell us? Do you have any expectation? What you want us to take note of particularly about the course? So any of you can make comments if you want. Mutiata has reviewed to speak. Oh yeah, I'm listening, please.
Okay, ma'am. Can I go ahead?
You can go ahead, please.
Okay. I've gone through the material. I've done, let's say, module one, but there's a bit of confusion in terms of this PF and LF, because though there must be an interface, but I don't really get it well on this phonetic aspect, because that area is a bit not clear. But I don't know at what point the PF has to come in, and that's one of the major challenges I have. And I think that maybe that's why this the class will be helpful.
That we are here for you. Well, in the next class, we will talk about it. I'll make sure that I have enough time for this. If basically I don't teach you too, in GB syntax, if you have come across BF, you know, before in the standard theory, it was called deep structure and surface structure. But now in GB syntax, which you have actually encountered towards the end of your 222, you should actually have gotten an idea of what we are talking about. But we are going to
even the DS and the deep structure and surface structure seem to pose some difficulties even at that particular time we did it, because we don't really know at what point this structure and S structure have to,
this structure is actually supposed to be the semantic base for the structure. You understand now? Why the surface structure is actually the phonetic realization? You understand what I'm saying now? So when you talk about the LF, which is logical form, form still has to do, when you know semantics, and I think you people did it in 300 level, when you talk about the logical form, talking about the meaning. It's okay, but generally TGG doesn't believe in meaning. But the reality is that there's no language without meaning. And that has been the argument. But TGG will tell you there's nothing like meaning. So that is just the truth of the matter. But then we will talk more about this. So when you talk about LF, you're talking about the logical form. When you talk about the LF, it's actually talking about the logical form, and the PF is actually the phonetic form. So essentially, that is it. If you don't understand that, then you know the basics. But we are going to talk about it more in the next class. I'm hoping I'm going to have a bit of quietness. I will not have disturbance there. So I hope it's a bit clear now, Najakaye.
Yes, my it's a bit clear.
But you too, please. I've given you an idea now. When you talk about logical form, and then we talk about so.
I think it's clear. I'm clear about the logical form. It's just that at what point will I be able to identify the that phonetic form is my problem, because I keep wondering. Okay, if we talk about phonetic form, what actually constitutes this in that particular theory? So that's my challenge, and I've been trying to look at even in the. I tried to download the.
Please go and subscribe. All of you go and subscribe to my channel. All the videos of the last class are there. Go and subscribe to my channel and watch them. I did extensive discussion of those things, so it will prepare you. It is the channel is Omolara Wabwezi. So just go and subscribe to it. I did extensive teaching on those things. I don't know, because the way they won't flow to the other is easier when you talk about the structure and surface structure. But in the case of this one, the phonetic form and the ideology form kind of connect, then they now get realized as this at the spell out stage. But then you can actually have a realization, even that okay. I don't know, but we'll talk about it in the next class. Let me just leave it for that. Because to be sincere, okay. It's just on that they may call us anytime. So that is just okay. The one flows into the other. And that is when you look at this particular grammar, it starts with what? It starts with the lexemes. And that's why you have the operation select.
Okay.
So it starts with the lexemes. Okay. So even at the more syntactic level, you're having the structures, the meaning already being built into it. And that relates to gamma and the alpha. So all these things, we will discuss them in the next class. So, but right. It's not really as difficult as it looks.
Okay, ma'am. Now,
then even if yes, you ma'am. See that by the time we are doing the practical analysis, I mean, you can still bring it up if you are still not clear by then. You can still bring up this, ma'am. But it's not the form essentially is about the meaning. The phonetic form is about the realizations. That is what it's
represented. Okay.
Yes. But you see now that between them, by the time you get into the spell out stage and all of them getting to being branching into this thing, they merge and then they become the structure. But the base for what is it? When you say the boss, so what are you talking about? So but when you look at most of the syntactic components, you'll be able to get that. And then when it gets pronounced, it then becomes that particular structure.
Okay, I think I'm getting something out of it, yeah.
Happy about that. So we'll discuss more about that later. So please,
okay.
Do you have any other
friend
that has any challenge or any question?
Excuse me, I want to ask the question.
Okay, go ahead, please.
What is like the practical application of these theories in the real world? I really do not understand how this comes in, how we're going to apply it in the real world. Is it during sentence making or during speeches? I really do not understand.
You speak a language, do you not?
Yes, ma. Yes, ma.
Okay. Now, what you're doing is that you are scientifically studying the way before the doctor will know how to prescribe for you. They have actually studied the components of the elements of the drugs. And they say now, okay, this you are complaining about. This is what it's about. Then they will now use it to give you that, okay, this one can help you to take out that thing that is causing that pain. So now when you are doing this, you are studying the structure of the language. And at times, like I was telling some my colleagues today, I told them, I said, what called the World War II? You know what? It's a misunderstanding. No?
What, ma?
Somebody, an interpreter, said the wrong thing. If I watch H.E.K.U., I don't know what the name of that guy that used to interpret for white people in the court, in one Igbo drama. The man will say something, and you say another thing, we go and say, the man said he should slap you. Now the man, I don't know, maybe in the language the man say they say that that man kicked the person. This person now say that the man said that he don't say somebody kicked somebody. Now say that they said they should kick you. Now if somebody tell you that, what will you do? Will you not react and start fighting? Will you not react and start fighting? But that's not what that man said. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, so
yes.
Okay, please.
Yes, ma'am. Sorry, yes, ma'am.
I have to end the class now because the VC said we should come in now. So please, we'll continue in the next class. Thank you so much. And
thank you.
I will post this video later so that you can watch it again if you have questions. Okay.
Right.
So,
yeah. Bye. Thank you, ma. Bye-bye, ma.
Yeah. Okay, ma. Bye. Thank you, ma. Bye-bye, ma.
Bye.